My name's John. I'll teach you all about safe practices with projectile weapons.
And I'm Tyler, and I'll be teaching you hunting 101.
Please buy beans that are the best in the whole world, called Bush's Best Beans. Enjoy!
Oh, hello! My name is Gertrude Sharpley Cutsalot, and I'm here to tell you all about whittling in this 30-minute whittling course. You're gonna make an awesome, safe project at home. Now, the first step to whittling is making sure that you have a blood bubble. Now, to make sure you have a blood bubble, turn around in a 360-degree radius of a circle. Then, if you touch anything or anyone, you'll know that they are at risk of being cut. Now, when whittling, make sure never to go towards yourself. You could get yourself hurt, and that would be very, very bad. Now, make sure that you always have a strong grip on the knife and on the object. Your thumb should be pushing the knife forward so that you have complete control over what you are doing. Now, once you are done with the whittling process, make sure to sandpaper down your awesome project. Once you've done that, your object should be finished. This is a spoon I've made, and as you can see, I've sanded it down a lot. Process, it can go from looking like this to looking like this. Remember, you should always have complete control over your knife. Have fun and whittle safely!
Plants in the woods, we have sourwood. Sourwood's leaves are very yummy and they're edible too. Would you like to try some?
Sure.
Tyler, what about you? You sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Well, let's continue.
No. Oh no.
Being safe with the food you eat in the woods is crucial to your survival. As we showed you with poison ivy, it can have very bad results. Now, on to our next topic. Now, when you see a bear with her cubs, you should never interfere, because bears that think you are dangerous will attack, and you don't want to get hurt.
Sourwood.
Wait,
Tyler,
no,
I don't
Tyler,
think that's not, that's
Tyler,
not.
I think that's poison ivy.
So, knife throwing is one of the most important skills you can have. It will protect you from bears and allow you to hunt things like rabbits. So, you need to know how to do it. Step one is what you gotta do is you gotta open your knife blade. Like this. Make sure to use a locking blade because it won't close in your fingers and chop them off. Because you don't want to be eating your fingers and you could be eating a rabbit. Step two, you find a target. You make sure everyone is behind you when you're throwing your knife so you don't stick anybody. That's no fun for the person being sticked. Step three, throw the knife very carefully at your target. It may take a little bit of practice. Ta-da.
Good job.
Anyone want to try?
Sure.
I'll get the knife.
No, no,
Tyler,
no, no,
wait!
No! 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 Oh.
Watch out, America! There have been wild wolf sightings all over the country!
Roar!
Hello!
Roar!
Hello, and welcome to Hunting Survival 101. There are three main weapons used in the woods.
Okay, so the main weapons are a gun.
Are you alright, sir?
Yes, I'm a professional. A knife, and then a slingshot. I'm going to teach you how to use the slingshot.
Good.
So, it's very simple. All you do is you pull back the string and then release, and it should fire.
Good.
Would anyone like to volunteer as tribute?
I would, sir.
Okay, here.
Thank you.
Okay, so you can take some of the ammo, and I will put this on my head, and you can try and shoot it off.
Sounds fun, sir.
Doesn't want to stay on.
Do you need help with that?
No, I'm a professional.
All right, sir. I'll leave you to it. I did it! I hit the can!
Yes, you did. Now maybe we need a little bit more power.
You want the slingshot?
No.
Oh, why? Oh my goodness! What?
Uh-oh.
Now, when you see a bear, never interfere. You should leave it alone because bears that think that you are dangerous will attack you.
Hey, look, sourwood.
Hey, wait, stop, that's poison ivy. Tyler!
Cut.